Hello, Dissenters. My name is Italics, and I am here today with more Banished here in the town of Boulderline, which appears to be thriving by all accounts. Allow me to display why. 54,000 food. We're not going to be starving anytime soon, and we still got a little room for growth. I've had to continually take people off of their jobs and tasks in order to give us a better pool of laborers. There's a lot of kids, but they're not graduating fast enough to restore our labor. So what we're going to do is work on making some more homes and houses, which I've already got ready to go, just FYI. So you're not going to have to watch me find a new placement for them way down to the southwest. This is where the new civilization is going in, our brand new market, which accidentally got halfway full when I forgot to turn off the work. So people were walking all the way down here to get food to take back to their homes way in the middle of nowhere. So first things first, let's get a few of these homes and houses unpaused and ready for construction. Gonna take some of our stone and logs. I'm thinking we're just gonna get one quadrant. So I'm gonna crank up the number of builders, and we're also going to turn down the number of food gatherers at the moment to try to give us some extra laborers, and those laborers are going to be who are taking the resources to and fro, and we'll refill the fishermen and the gatherers as we get more laborers at our disposal. But for the time being, this is going to be a good place to start, and as soon as these homes are constructed, we're going to resume work with the market, because at the time being, there's still food here, so you can still see people walking to gather the food from the market to take back to their homes, so these guys are still going to have a limited supply for the time being. Alright, good stuff. I've got some roads being constructed as well to connect these guys to the rest of civilization. Hard to see, but there's a road right here where my mouse is, leading all the way down to where the fishing dock is, and one on the other side mirroring it, as well as a secondary road going alongside our brand new Forester's Lodge, right up along here and connecting to this quadrant of the new town. So, new town within our city. It's kind of exciting, so it's going to make town number 3. And we'll have room, of course, for town number 4 way out here at some point in the distant future, perhaps. It looks like, unfortunately, one of our mines has emptied, leaving us with 15 extra people without a job. We'll make a new mine. We'll start working on one. But for the time being, these guys are going to be great additional laborers. So we're going to be able to restock some of our fishermen, for example, and a few of our gatherers. And, of course, we definitely want farmers. Those guys are going to be super important, planting in the spring. And yes, I know we have way too much food at the moment, but the more the better, I say. I think that's going to be all... How did this home burn down? How did this get damaged? I don't think I ever saw this happen. This is about a perfect spot for a new mine. I know that mines and quarries are kind of checkering my map at the moment, but it's way out here in the middle of nowhere, to the east of our secondary town. Right next to a currently existing mine and quarry, kind of where we're hiding all the ugly things in the city. So it'll be an okay spot right there. And we just want to get that going ahead of time because we've got a good 73% in that mine, 50% in this mine. So it is starting to get a little bit low, but nothing to be too concerned about. One house is done, 3 more nearly there. And then 2 kind of lagging behind just a little bit, but people are going to be starting to live here and enjoy the brand new market that I've built for them. And of course, we've got some more jobs that they can work at to the far west. And bridges have been completed connecting these little islands back to the main sections of town. Granted, there aren't really any roads right now, so I guess we can go ahead and designate one such road to connect to these 2 bridges. And then probably want something to connect us to the main section of town way out here. So we're just gonna get a big long road like this. I know people aren't even gonna use that road. Look what I found. Look at this. The conga line of nomads arriving in town to sell us their wares. Hello, my beautiful friends. How are you this day? 75 nomads want to gain access to our lovely city. It's been a long time since I've accepted nomads. I had to decline them. I even went so far as to say no more nomads in the last episode, but I'm going back on that. We're allowing 75 nomads, which gives us the achievement, the award for village, because we have over 600 citizens, 644 to be exact, with a ton of laborers. So you know, before we even unpause again, the first thing we need to do is, of course, bring our food capacity back up to maximum. 64 fishermen, we got maximum hunters, foresters, herbalists. I think everything is completely maxed out. The only thing we have left to pump more citizens into is a working market, So we're going to turn the work back on here and then pump in 12 more vendors to make 36. And then we got 23 spare to work with. All right, so this is kind of scary. I know, I am aware of how scary this is. There's a lot of things that we need to do. We need to start working on more homes and houses to give these people a place to rest their head and call their own, somewhere apart from the multitude of boarding houses that are now filled up across the city. We're having the Summer Olympics here in Boulderline, and boarding houses, hotels everywhere are filled to the brim to watch the festivities. Now, since we do have houses way out here now, people close to potential jobs, I think it's a great idea to get things like this hunting cabin under construction and the Forester's Lodge eventually. I'm not going to focus on that yet. Herbalist is good because we are always low on herbs, and here comes a trader. Let's take a look over here. Our farms should be ready for some planting. What should we grow here? Pumpkins. I don't think we have any pumpkins around here. And then since beans are so far away, let's take the other field and make some beans for our people. Okay, so we're going to need to add in some more farmers to compensate for that. 118, and we can just leave about 10 builders. They'll get the job done eventually. We'll have to pay them overtime. They're going to be working so hard. But as you can see, two boarding houses are now empty. How about the boarding house over here? It's empty as well. Do we have enough homes for everybody now? I think we might have done so. Let's check our overview. 658 citizens at the moment. Graphs are going up, 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 up. We did have a little bit of a dip in population with that nasty starvation. We've almost reached year 100, which is crazy. And of course, the moment we've all been waiting for, sheep pens are actively producing mutton. Almost 1,600 per season. That is crazy. This one's producing 800 per season. The chicken infestation, whatever, has finally evened out, and they are all well now. So we're still making chicken and eggs here. I think I'm going to get rid of these chickens. So we've got, what, 3 chicken pens right now? These chickens just don't produce as much food as the sheep. So I think we're going to kill every single one of these chickens. Just slaughter them all. I just want to watch this mass slaughter happen as they kill all chickens one by one with reckless abandon. They don't even care anymore. What I'm planning on doing is having sheep overtake the chickens. The sheep are our new animal overlords. We don't have any more room for little chickies in this colony anymore because they just don't give us enough food. So I'm going to split the herd of the sheep here, put 12 in each one, and get 2 of these giant 25 sheep pens side by side. I know that's really bad if the event that they develop another illness, but this chicken pen is just such a waste of space. Despite the challenges that we faced, somehow we're coming out on top with 50,000 food again. We've bounced back. Those nomads were sure hungry when they first came to town, but we have managed to sate them. Okay, building more homes and houses now. Let's just queue up another 6 for this other quadrant, which is going to leave 1 quadrant remaining next to this market. This just seems like a good idea. This market's 100% full? That's crazy. Oh, look, these buildings have been completed. So we need to add in some more workers. 24 hunters. Let's see, we got a herbalist now too, so 2 more herbalists. Do we have... Yes, the gatherer's hut has been completed also. So that's going to be 4 more gatherers. And then we can start work on the Forester's Lodge while we're at it. The only thing we're at a negative on is clothing, so I'm glad that I kind of nipped that in the bud right now. We're also consuming a lot more alcohol. People are getting a little bit more upset. And we've also got more coal going in than is coming out. All right, so that kind of gives me an early warning that we're going to need to make some more clothing, another tailor perhaps. So instead, we're going to have 2 tailors. One is going on the outside. I'm going to save the inside for homes and houses. It just seems like a good idea, so I'm moving this one a little bit over. So 2 tailors going in side by side. We do have an infestation, which is not ideal. Let's see where it is. Okay, it is an orchard, but nothing similar is nearby. So that's okay. We could even cut down these trees if we want to. Though we are getting almost 1,000 cherries, so that's good. The pasture is finally empty. All right, sheep it is. And we're going to split the herd. I know, guys, I know the risks. Okay. We will take the risks. Split the sheepies up. They should enter this pasture, and they should start growing into adult sheepies. And we're going to have 25 more of them, and we're going to be producing like 2,300 mutton between them per season. And some corn. Apparently, these sheep are spitting out corn for our people to eat, so getting a little extra bonus food from them. Dunna, 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 like swimming with the trader. What could he possibly have for us to trade with? Oh, and another trader was in front of him the whole time. Food trader, see you later. How about you, sir? I hope you have something better. Oh, I'm going to take all your food by... Oh, seriously, he's got so much. We need some kind of armed robbers. Mafia to just commandeer their vessels. Some pirate ships out in the bay. What if we just build a pirate ship in this lake? One in this lake, and the other in this lake, and they're just gonna shoot cannonballs back and forth at each other until the other one sinks. And we'll use it as an entertainment venue to bring more nomads to the city. Today is a momentous day. We celebrate a century of Borderline. Year 100 is now in full swing. So how awesome is that, guys? We made it through 100 years of Borderline together. That's nuts. It blows my mind. I am boggled. You can consider me boggled. We do need, of course, the one thing we always need, more food. I'm hoping that once these sheepies grow back up, we're going to be able to quell that need, because we have been negative just a little bit. But I think it's time to go nuts with fishing docks, because we've pretty much colonized everything around this section of the water. See how there's no fishing docks at all? There's at least room for 4 more fishing docks, if not 5. Number 3. Okay, right here. So there's the area of influence. I know this is going to overlap just a teeny bit. There we go. There's like at least 4 or 5 more fishing docks that are going to be built in there. I'll wait until they're constructed to work on the roads. But we have plenty of laborers to fill in those slots, and I just want a little bit of a buffer of food. I know fishing docks don't produce a ton of food. Well, I take that back. 1,453, because it's right next to this storage barn. It's full of fish. These guys are actually making quite a bit. This guy's only 661. Those fishers kind of suck by comparison, which reminds me it's probably going to be a good idea to place some storage barns in between these little fishing docks. So I know this is kind of an awkward spot for one, but let me make sure that we have room for it to walk around. So that's really close to these two fishing docks, as well as helping us out with the hunting cabin, herbalist, and forester's, well, not the forester's lodge, but you get the idea. And then one more storage barn in between. Be nice. So let's make sure we have enough room, and there we go. Okay, so all those buildings are gonna start being constructed. We are running really low on logs. We do have 28 foresters. And that's going to take up most of our reserves, so hopefully we don't have a firewood shortage. In the meantime, it's probably worthwhile to start working on a new forester's lodge way out here, kind of in the middle of nowhere almost. But this is like the perfect circle, let's be honest. I'm also noticing that our schools have become full, and you know where a perfect place for a school is going to be? You guessed it. Over in the new side of town, where nothing currently exists right now except for a bunch of homes and uneducated children. So let's just make a schoolhouse again on the outside here. Seems like as good a spot as any. I know we're starting to infringe upon our friends right here, but they still got plenty of room to work with. So a new schoolhouse is going to allow for 20 more students. It might be worthwhile to have 2 schoolhouses and just go ahead and nip that in the bud. We're kind of making a mirror town over here where everything is like the Twilight Zone. It's the same on one side of the street as the other. People aren't gonna know which direction to go. I want to thank you very much for watching this video as I add in all of these fishermen, like 14 more, as all of these docks have been constructed with storage barns still going up. Yes, one more still left to go. I almost forgot. We have pretty much no stockpiles in this whole sector of town. Okay, new stockpile going in right here, and we don't have any woodcutters. We need more woodcutters. We're almost out of firewood. Oh, well, of course I made the stockpile just one too big. We'll make the woodcutter over here on the other side instead. Just have it facing these guys. Why not? Okay, so yes, new woodcutter, new stockpile, because we got people chopping wood with nowhere to take it, and we're about to run out and freeze to death. But we're going to have to figure out how that works in the next episode, so stick around to see if they survive. If you like what you see in this video, please leave a like on the videos that you enjoy. I'd appreciate it very much. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Italics, and I will see you next time.